Several interventions in Uganda have been designed to help poor communities come out of poverty. Most of the interventions, however, have been seen to take on the charitable approach and not sustainable over time. Although it is reported that the poor have been reached, those in abject poverty have, however, been left out. Amongst these are the persons with disabilities. In 2009, Uganda National Action on Physical Disability, in collaboration with the National Union of the Disabled Persons in Uganda, piloted activities aimed at increasing participation of persons with disabilities in community initiatives using Village Loan and Savings Association's approach in two districts, Nebbi and Soroti. The Village Savings and Loan Associations, commonly known as VSLA groups, were formed with support of CARE Uganda, a non-governmental organization that works to reduce poverty among the poor through promoting savings. Mainstreaming persons with disabilities in this program was a good initiative, since it would help them to improve their livelihood, especially at household level. CARE, through her local partner, West Nile Private Sector Foundation, have implemented three phases of the SUSTAIN project since 2006. UNIPID also entered into agreement with West Nile Private Sector in Nebbi District to mobilize and capture data on persons with disabilities who joined the groups. The documentary captures the success stories, experience, and challenges of inclusion of persons with disabilities in VSLA. Persons with disabilities comprise the biggest part of the poorest Ugandans in every district. According to the United Nations statistics, persons with disabilities comprise 10% of any given population. This means that Nebbi has over 50,000 persons with disabilities out of the district's total population of 500,000. This is a very big number of people that CARE and UNIPID could not achieve their objectives of eradicating poverty among the poor when not specifically targeted. VSLA are groups formed at village level for the purpose of improving members' economic and social livelihood through savings and borrowing. Each group comprises between 15 to 30 members of fairly the same financial status. They choose an executive committee headed by a chairperson, secretary, and a treasurer. Having a business is one of the major conditions to join a VSLA group. It also works on the principle of self-selection, where members freely join of their choice. When the groups form, they go through 7 stages of training offered by a community-based trainer. Each member pays 1,000 shillings for all the trainings. When they're ready to start saving, they buy a cash box at a cost of 75,000 shillings from West Nile Private Sector. To avoid cases of cheating and robbery, they make a metallic box complete with 3 padlocks. The keys to each padlock are kept by 3 different designated group members, and they all have to be present to open the cash box. The treasurer keeps only the cash box, but not any of the keys. Each group meets once a week, and each member is supposed to have saved a stipulated amount of money. Some groups save 500, 1,000, or even 5,000 per member, depending on their financial status. They come with it all at the meeting. When it accumulates, they start borrowing. Each member has a passbook where they record their weekly savings in form of stars. Each star represents a fixed amount of money each group member saves per week. At any time, a member counts his or her number of stars to determine how much they have so far saved. This gives an opportunity to even the illiterate to know their savings. All members share their accumulated savings and interest at the end of each year. Most members borrow small loans as little as 10,000 shillings, but realize big changes in their petty businesses. The most common businesses are selling fish, cassava, beans, and rearing goats. Repayment of the loan and interest of between 5 to 20% is made per week for a period not exceeding 3 months. Each group has 2 money counters who receive money from members. Since West Nile Private Sector started mobilizing persons with disabilities to join VSLA groups, there are 35,000 beneficiaries out of which 278 have disabilities. This is Mirka Mungu Group in Nebbi Sub-County. The group's name means with love of God. They meet every Thursday of the week. They've collected 680,000 shillings from this meeting through payment of loans, interest and fines. The chairperson asks members who wish to get loans and how much each wants to borrow. The candidates are vetted to see whether they qualify to take loans depending on their kind of businesses. Loan repayment history is credit and cooperation organizations promoted and supported by the government, but they are marred by several cases of fraud and mismanagement. However, it was not easy to include persons with disabilities in the group.
At that time, the coordinator from Lodipo came and gathered almost all the trainers, and the program itself talks of self-selection. And people, since people with disability were people who were somehow underrated among the community, they were ever underrating them. But when we came up with the information, with those information given by the Lodipo people, that people with disability are equal like other people, then we started even sensitizing the community on how people with disability should be handled, how they are equal to others, how they can even do saving. Then people begin to understand that there is no difference between them and people with disability. So the people with disability started joining. And when they join, in fact, me, I found that they are more active even than the able people.
Aloysius Oloya, a community-based trainer, says the able-bodied people at first marginalized people with disabilities.
But when she joined, at first when she was joining, even people were even underrating her because she moved on wheelchair. Secondly, she has ear problem also. If you are to talk to her, you have to talk very loudly. So people were underrating, but when she came in, coupled with the information we got from people of Lodipo, I managed to handle her very well. And even up to now, when she sees me, she talks very well.
This group has 29 members. After the death of its 30th member, it is called Mungu Bitimo, meaning God will do everything. Only one member, a woman, has a disability. She is partially blind. The group of only women started 5 years back and has since been very active. Members say they don't want men in the group for fear of bullying them. Julie Nyenga is the chairperson of Mungu Bitimo Group. She says they were sensitized about including persons with disabilities in VSLA groups when their group was already full. She, however, says since they have lost one of their group members, they will replace her with a person with disability.
This group is now in the fifth year.
Atiye ko dano piro bungwena, ngabere sa ko dano pira dek, eka no ko dano piro bungwena.
The group had 30 members, but now they are 29. And out of the 29, there is one person with disability.
She says the blind member in her group is very active and her savings are better than those of many able-bodied people. Members in the group are involved in rearing chicken, goats and selling fish. Julie Nyenga is able-bodied She owns a canoe used for fishing on River Nile. She makes a lot of money in her business, and she is paying tuition for her son at Makerere University. She also has a grandson in senior six. She has been in the group for 5 years. She says she would not have achieved much if it was not because of VSLA. Hudson Chikao is a program officer of West Nile Private Sector and is in charge of 31 VSLA groups. He says persons with disabilities had initially been left out in the VSLA program, thinking they would not fit in the program, but have now come on board. There are now 117 persons with disabilities in this working area who have joined VSLA. They have begun saving to improve their livelihood. Ngamita Kutansia has a physical disability and moves with the aid of a walking stick, but this did not deter fellow members to entrust her with the group's money. She is their treasurer in spite of her shyness. She's a mother of one child of 7 years. She's able to look after him through her business of selling groundnuts. The group members have faith in God